everyone, welcome to the course of microwave engineering. In today's session we are going to learn about cavity magnetron. This cavity magnetron is also called as cylindrical traveling wave magnetron, where as we have seen previous tubes where they are also used for amplification as well as the oscillation of the signals or to generate some frequencies. Now similar to that, this cavity magnetron is also a high power vacuum tube used to increase the frequency of the signal. So this, as you see here, this is a diagram of a cavity magnetron where you can see several cavities. So this multi-cavity device are available in 8 to 20 cavities. So here what we see here is around some 8 cavities. We also get these cavity magnetrons up to 20 cavities, okay? And the frequency of this cavity or this cavity magnetron frequency ranges from 0.6 gigahertz to 30 gigahertz. So this is an structure of a cavity magnetron, and these are the cavities what we see here. Okay, let's see one by one the simplified structure of a cavity magnetron, why these cavities are used and what's happening over there. Let's see one by one. So this is a simple construction of a magnetron where you can see several cavities. So these cavities are like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So we are considering an 8 cavity magnetron where the center part is our cathode. So this one. So this center part is our cathode and these plates. So the junctions, what you see here at the cavities, between the cavities, okay? These are considered as anode plates, okay? And these circular parts are considered as cavities, okay? And the space between or the space around this particular cathode. So here what you see, the space around this particular cathode is considered as interaction chamber, and this particular knob over here is an inlet of RF signal. Okay, so on the whole, a simple construction of a magnetron, if we consider, it consists of a cathode, it consists of anode plates, and it consists of circular cavities, and also it consists of an RF input. Okay, this is what a simple structure of a magnetron or the construction looks like. Okay, now let's see a three-dimensional construction of a magnetron. So this simple construction of a magnetron has been converted into three-dimensional or the 3D structure of a magnetron. If you see here, the center part, what you see here, this gold one, is nothing but our cathode. And these plates, what you see here around the cavities, are considered as anode plates. And this particular rod is considered as RF input. Okay. And this particular cathode is connected with a battery over here, like this. Okay, through which the supply is given. Let us say this is positive and this is negative. Okay, this is a supply over here where we can give it to a cavity magnetron. So a cavity magnetron has been supplied some energy such that the electrons will be flowing towards the cavities or towards the anode plates. So what happens when an RF signal is given into the cavity magnetron? So what happens whenever the electrons try to start moving towards the anode plates or the cavity, how the energy will be generated, we will be seeing it in the coming slides. Coming to the working of a magnetron, here we have three conditions. One condition where there exists only electric field, That means magnetic field will be zero. So let's see the first condition when there is only electric field in the magnetron and when the magnetic field is zero. Okay. If you see the diagram over here, these are our circular cavities and these are our anode plates, and these are our cathode, and this is the interaction place. Okay. So whenever a supply is given, this cathode will be keep on. So this cathode will be keep on emitting electrons towards the circular cavities. And as there is only existence of electric field, the electrons will be straightly traveling towards this circular cavity, and these electrons will experience an electric field at the anode plates. So whatever the electrons exhibiting by the cathode, as there exists only electric field, these electrons will be straightly traveling towards the anode plates, and they will be experiencing the electric field at the anode plates. You can clearly see over here, the electric field is traveling from the negative to the positive, and there is no magnetic field at this particular point. Okay. So here, the first condition is there exists only electric field in the magnetron, and the magnetic field is zero at this particular point. So whenever the magnetic field is zero and there exists only electric field, the electrons from the cathode will be traveling in a straight path towards the anode plates. Okay, this is how what happens when an electron is traveling from a cathode towards an anode plates, and there is no magnetic field at all. So the electrons from an anode will be traveling through the interaction place towards the anode plates. Okay. And you can clearly observe the electric field interaction at that place where the magnetic field is zero. This is our first condition we need to consider. Okay. Next. So in the second condition of a magnetron, where there exists a magnetic field. So we already know when these both electric field and magnetic field at these particular M-type tubes are perpendicular to each other. So let's assume this is a cavity magnetron where we can see the electric field is traveling from a cathode to an anode plates, and you can see a slight curve at the particular travel of the electrons. As there exists a magnetic field, you can clearly see as the electric field is perpendicular to the magnetic field. If you see here, as the electrons are moving towards the anode plates, the magnetic field is coming out of this particular magnetron. That means here you can clearly observe that the electric field and magnetic field are both are perpendicular to each other. And as there is an existence of magnetic field as well as electric field, whenever the electrons are traveling from cathode to towards anode plates, as there is a magnetic field existence, you can clearly observe the electric fields or the electrons traveling towards the anode plates have a little bit bent. Okay, you can see the electrons are taking a little bit of diversion whenever they are traveling through an interaction space towards this particular anode plates. This only happens when there is an existence of magnetic field, and you can clearly observe the magnetic field which is perpendicular to our electric field in this particular diagram. This is our second condition. Okay, let's coming to the third condition. Let us say the magnetic field is very much high compared to the electric field. Okay, that is our third condition. See, in this case, the magnetic field is very high. Okay, so whenever the magnetic field is high, these particular electrons which are traveling from cathode towards the anode plates tend to take a turn. Okay, as the magnetic field is very, very high than the electric field, the magnetic field or the electrons coming from the cathode will take a turn and again reaches the cathode. This happens when a magnetic field is very, very high. Okay, so what happens here is, as the electrons are taking a diversion and again coming towards the cathode, these electrons form into a bunch. Okay, so this is what where the bunching effect happens. So obviously, when the magnetic field is high, the electrons which are moving towards the anode plates are taking a diversion and coming back to the cathode again. This is what's happening whenever the magnetic field is huge in the magnetron. So this is where the bunching effect of an electron is taking place, where the all the electrons are gathered at a one place and they are having a bunch. Okay, now at this condition, whenever an RF field is given as an input, that means whenever an RF field is, or the radio frequency is high, given as an input, and as the magnetic field is high and there is a bunching effect taking place, that means the electrons are taking a diversion from the cathode and again reaching the cathode. And when the bunching effect is taking place, the velocity modulation happens. So let's see this one. So velocity modulation happens when a magnetic field is high as well as an RF is given as an input. So these electrons tend to move towards the cathode itself by taking a divergence, okay, through which a bunching effect is experienced. And these electrons are accelerated by the RF field, imparting the energy to the oscillations to take the energy from the oscillations, resulting in the increased velocity. That means the velocity modulation has been increased, due to which the frequency also increases. So first thing what we need to remember is the first condition: whenever the magnetic field is very, very high and whenever the RF signal is given as an input, that means RF signal is high, the electrons are responsible for the bunching effect. Okay, so that means the electrons will be taking a diversion and again reaching this particular cathode. At this particular point, this energy will be taking an oscillations, which resulting in an increased velocity, due to which the frequency will be increased. That is how an amplification or the generation of the signal happens. So on the whole, a cavity magnetron consists of cavities. That cavities depends from 8 to 20 cavities. It consists of a cathode as well as anode plates along with an RF signal. Okay, so whenever this magnetron takes three conditions, whenever the first condition is like whenever it experiences only electric field, okay, the electrons will be traveling in a straight path from a cathode to an anode plates. So whenever there exists both electric and magnetic field, the electrons will be taking a little bit of turn, and these both electric and magnetic field will be perpendicular to each other. Third condition plays a vital role for increasing the frequency or the amplification of the signal, where the velocity modulation happens. As the magnetic field is going higher and higher, the electrons which are moving towards the anode plates from the cathode take diversion towards cathode again, which results in bunching effect or bunching of an electrons. And at this point, whenever a RF signal is given as an input, these both combine and generate a huge energy, which helps in increasing the frequency or increasing the velocity modulation. This is how a magnetron works.